Hey guys, it's Steve and I. Today I'd like to talk about a very fun hobby that I have picked up over the last couple of years. It started... Okay, so there's a neighborhood kind of close to my house that can only do yard sales twice a year. And so twice a year, everyone in the whole housing development, and it's hundreds of houses, has a yard sale at the same time. And one of my friends alerted me to this, and we decided to go and check it out. When we went there, it was so surprising. A lot of the time, people were just handing me things and saying, "Take it, we don't want it. You don't have to pay me anything." Or they would give me something like really nice for like 50 cents. And I was like, well, this is pretty cool. I can get some great deals for things, for items that I would find really useful. And sometimes items that I wouldn't really think to buy just because they were out of my price range, but I can get them at a yard sale for much cheaper and actually try them out. And usually they work. Everyone gets confused when I talk about yard sailing. I go 2 out of 3 weekends because of my work schedule, so 2 out of 3 Saturdays I go yard sailing for a couple of hours in the morning. Sometimes I take people with me, and people are always asking me, like, how do you find the yard sales? Do you look at ads, or do you just know? But really, it's as easy as just following the signs, because go down a main street, and you'll see signs saying this way, that way, this way, and you just follow them, and you follow them until you get to the yard sale. It's pretty obvious when someone has a yard sale in their yard. But I always ask, is this a yard sale? Just in case it's not a yard sale. Always smart to bring some yard sailing ones. Small bills, quarters are also good. I always go in with a budget because I don't want to just spend money on things I don't need. I want to actually think about how this would be useful and try to get a good price for it. So my budget, each time I yard sale, I have $20. And a lot of the time I don't even use that. Sometimes I'll spend like 7 on smaller items, a piece of clothing and something nice, and I'll carry over that money from that week that I didn't spend to the next week, so that eventually if I save up enough money, I can buy a larger item. And sometimes I do find good large items for sale for good deals. One example of some of these items, there is a brand. It is a brand of cookware and appliances called Perini. And Perini makes a lot of different pieces to their collection. And they're actually really good quality. I buy them for like, I got a slow cooker, like a proper large slow cooker in the box and plastic, brand new, never used before, for $8. And I'm like, $8? That's amazing for a slow cooker still in the box. So I've been trying to collect different pieces of Perini cookware and appliances over the couple of years that I've been yard sailing. I have a pretty good collection of it so far, and it's all really useful stuff that works amazing and was really cheap. Every once in a while, I'll buy a more expensive item from Perini, but I mean, it's still a price that would be reasonable to pay at a store for the thing that I'm buying. Another thing I try to do when I go yard sailing is to not only have a budget, but also have a goal in mind. I don't want to just randomly shop for nothingness. I would say, okay, well, today I want to get a jacket because it's getting colder and my old jacket's wearing out. And there was one day, it was so weird, but I got up in the morning and I said, okay, there are 2 things that I want today. I want to find Spider-Man 2 on DVD, number 2 only. And I also want to find the Perini rectangular blue enamel-coated cast iron lasagna pan, Perini branded, which I saw someone else had online. And those are my 2 goals. And guess what? I only just found both of them on that one trip. It was so weird, but it was cool. It was also kind of funny. And that's one of the things I love about yard sales, because they're unpredictable, but sometimes things just work out the way you want them to, and it's always fun, and you don't really waste any money buying things you don't really need, because even if it doesn't work out for you, you only spent $1 on it. So the rest of this video, I want to do a yard sale haul. This isn't everything I've bought, because sometimes I buy things for other people, sometimes I buy smaller things for around the house, but I'm going to share with you all of the different pieces of clothing. For the most part, I got for $1. The larger jackets I got for between 1 and 5. A good half of my wardrobe is yard sale items. I'm also gonna show you my Perini collection and show you the prices for those. Thank you. So this is a fun hobby that I think you should try, maybe. It's really fun. It is a great way for you and a friend to go out and spend the morning together. You get cool stuff out of it, and it's cheap and still reasonably good quality. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm proud of my yard sale haul, and I'm excited to keep spending time with people, just having fun, and finding great deals on things. Hope you have a great day. Happy hunting. See you guys.